Hey guys, this is Mitch, aka Demolition Missions here, giving you guys the heat lineups for Derby Day number one, Bash for Cash, Washington Courthouse, Ohio. So it started off, this is supposed to be heat one right here lined up. And I'm not sure if they're going to do all the heats in order of the same class, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then do the next class, or they're going to alternate one class and the next class and one. And I know on WeCrash on the internet they were debating it, and I believe most people wanted to see every other. So we'll just go through and check out what we all got going on and see what passed and what hasn't. And that thing is sitting high. Wow. Nice engine, not in cage on her. Yeah, this is that team we saw earlier. The other cars, a bunch of drivers, that team. This is all the 80s and newer class. If anyone was wondering, I'm walking out right now. I'm not sure on the rules for bumpers. I don't remember if they're allowed to load bumpers here or not. We'll find out when we see them bending. Got a good helmet in that car. Is this a Buick? That guy might be. Or a Caprice. Can't tell. It's not a Ford though. What we got over here? See side door Lincoln? Yes, we do. Holy cow. Didn't expect to see one of them here. That is a 60s Ford suicide door Lincoln. Those cars have mean front ends. Mean front ends. These are the ones you'll see run at Metal Mayhem a lot. You see the front, they put a good pointy bumper on that. I think it's going to destroy axles. This will be a fun car to watch run. Look for this one. In the class. You guys know what heat this car is in?
Four.
Four? Alright, I'll be looking for it. Heat four. CadillacHeaven.com. I wonder what that website is. Hey, anyone that's watching this video, somebody go to that website and tell me what it is, because I want to know. I'll forget it now, but put it in the video so one of you guys that gets bored will look it up. Ex-cop car over there. Wonder if it has the cop car frame. Here's a Fifth Ave right there, son of a gun. I'm gonna check it out in the next lineup. I was just talking about that in my previous video. A lot of wagons, like always. You will see a ton of roundback wagons in these derbies. Any big money show. What is this car? It looks like a Lincoln style. Is that a two-door Lincoln? Gotta be. Boy, I don't see many of these at all. Where the heck did this thing come from? Yeah, look at that. It says right there on the grill, Continental. That is a two-door Lincoln 60s Continental. Oh man, that thing's gonna fold weird. I bet you these corners of this bumper are gonna roll back towards the wheels, and that trunk's gonna shove in. The trunks on these 60s Lincolns are not good. You don't see them run anymore because you never find these cars, but I bet you that trunk packs in. It's always good to see they dedicate to the parents. Pop can in the corner. Someone must have shoved it in there walking by. It'll fall out. Right there in the corner. So these guys got the custom, you can buy these rims. I've been seeing a lot more people buying them now. It's getting harder to find steel rims. They only make aluminum ones. You can buy these already completely solid and put them on your cars. You can get them drilled for any bolt pattern. I like them. You gotta pay some money for them, but they're not gonna bend for a long time. And here's just what I was talking about in my first video. It's a non-Ford 80s and newer car. You really don't see many non-Ford 80 and newers run. Is this the same number of the car that ran last year with the Fifth Avenue? Or Diplomat, I mean the same kind of car. I'm not sure, might be the same guy. I really want to see what this car will do. I hardly ever see these things get actually built for sure like this. Usually they're more stock class cars. There's still cars rolling in, so I apologize if I don't get all the cars today. There's just so many to go through. So, another heat lineup right here. A little bit of a rusty body wagon. Here's that Cadillac we saw. And you really don't see too many older Cadillacs run anymore like you used to. I personally love 70s Cadillacs. They'd be fun to run, and they're just really good front-end cars. You can go mean with them for a while. I go on there, but I don't feel the poster. Two-door Buick. Moonshine for his name with the Monster logo. That's pretty cool. More people with those aftermarket rims I was talking about. Now here is a very old car. Possibly one of the oldest ones here, if not competing for the top five oldest cars running today. This thing's from the, late 50s to early 60s, I'm guessing. Anybody know what car this is for sure? Let me know in the video if you recognize it. I'd be curious to see how this car does. You don't see many of them running anymore, so it's hard to predict what it's gonna do, honestly, let alone build them. My guess is, as long as they hit soft, the back end's gonna roll up nice and pack in. But if one of these other cars gives them a real hard hit to the back, it's gonna just pop it straight in the air. It's clean too, not that rusty on the inside. It's an interesting way of reinforcing your rims. They welded plates on them so you can't bend the bead back right here and leak your air out. Very small back tires in this car. Good ones though, those are really great gripping tires. You guys ever seen these run? I've seen some figure eight guys use these kind of tires to get grips around the turns. There's a lot more two doors this year than I've seen before. You really don't see too many two doors before run, especially the older iron two doors. And this is probably the, I don't know, fifth or sixth two-door I've seen of old iron running. It's kind of cool. Don't know if people are just now deciding to run them because they couldn't find a four-door or if it's just what they found. Some of these roads are starting to get really crowded to walk between, but I'm going to try to make it, guys. We might have to cut through two at once. Is this heat three or four? Heat three right here? Okay, it's just the heat three lineup now. It does look like they are alternating them. They're having the 80s and newer as one heat, and they're going to do the old iron heat and 80s and newer and back and forth. So that's how they'll be having them. Obviously, when I upload these to YouTube, you guys are going to see them all the same heats. I'll do all the same class one after another, so you guys can keep track of it easier. I've seen somebody run that kind of wagon before. Might be the same guy I know. Seen him at some of the bigger shows. Another one of those Cadillac Heaven cars. That's ignorant. Boy, this thing is a rusty body and a rusty frame. Holy cow. This is gonna have to fight to survive out there. They're gonna eat it up. The name here, I don't know if you can see it on the door or not. Somebody actually carved Tony Stark in the door. Looks like Tony Stark. Could be Tom Stark. I can't read it. Looks like Tony. Wow, this thing has seen some weather. Whew. It's going to be rough running that against some of these guys. Coming up towards the end of the lineups here. One more heat lineup to go. Still looks like wagons are going to be pulling a heavy force at the show this year. Another very old school car right here. There's at least 10 cars that are in the 60s and early 70s range. Always good to see those old ones. I love seeing cars like that. You gotta watch them now because soon enough they're not gonna be around. Yep, there they're lining up even more heat lineups. They don't actually have them in their place yet. There is easily 200 cars this weekend, if not more, running. It was a great turnout. Great weather. They're not forecasting rain at all. It's not burning hot, not even 80s. It's upper 60s. This is the perfect weather you can have for a derby, for the fans and drivers. This right here is another suicide door Lincoln. It's the second one we've seen so far. Awesome. I mean, I just love these Fords from that age. Obviously, they're hard to buy. That's why I never have gotten one, but I do love them. The Mad Russian. That's an awesome name. I give him props. Whoever this car is, the driver's not here. That's cool. So, if you see this video, you hear me call you out now. Awesome name. most of these wagons I've been seeing, I don't know how well you guys can tell in the videos, obviously, but they are clean. I can see the interiors of them, the floors, the frames. There's not much rust in these wagons. People have been bringing these things from out west. They gotta be out west or real down south. And here's our last lineup for today. I really don't know how many cars they're gonna put in each heat. Find out once we film it. I'm guessing 15 to 20 per heat, probably. Juggalo Inc. Transmission cooler mounted in there. Wow, now there's a setup. This guy's rocking two batteries right up front. He can see what's going on, any problems. He's got a heck of a blower fan on his transmission cooler. That's not your normal electric fan on that. Looks industrial or a farm application use. That's nice. He's got a detached steering wheel here. If you guys know much about them, you take them off, they bolt in. There's actually a little divot there on the metal, and it pops in place, just like they do for NASCAR. Same exact setup. People just have been, within the last 5 years, that's really been catching on for the Derby world. And that's gonna give it for today. Derby day number one, heat lineups. Sorry for the long video, guys, but there's just a lot of cars to cover. Stay forward to tomorrow. I'll give you guys the lineups for Derby day number two.